If I ever took a loss, I learned a lesson. I won't ever think I'm better than the next man. I've been down before to come up, I ain't stressing. Baby, I'm too busy counting all these blessings. Yeah, yeah, yes, yeah. Yes.
Canada, Canada, Canada. Lanama, Lanama, Lanama. Swear the sun shining on me, get my huddle, no matter the trouble surrounding us. They don't see that it's a lot of us. Everybody move anonymous. Won't take that credit, I know what we get it. Them blessings be coming from God above. I was doing all kind of bad, what a quiet.
What's up, guys? It's Saturday, August 15th. We're getting ready to go to the track meet. Life University. I'm pretty excited. There's going to be a couple of elite vaulters there. It'll be a pretty cool experience. I'm going to talk to some of them and get some advice on different things, you know, mindset, you know, practice, me, just get some advice from them on what they think about. Yeah, we're hoping to jump a PR today like we did in practice, make that PR official. Yeah, so I'll get to the track. I might show you a little bit of the warm-up. I'll have my uncle record some of the videos of me actually vaulting, and I'll put those in there. And then I'll talk to you guys after the meet and see how it goes. Alright, so I'm gonna do a little bit of talking here so that you guys don't have to watch my videos with, you know, no sound. So today, I tried to come in at 11.6. I no-heighted on 3 attempts. I think the main issue, first of all, I was chasing a PR of 13. I set a goal earlier in the year that I wanted to get 13 before the end of the summer. And this is my last meet of the summer. So I think that I just put too much pressure on myself to try to hit that mark. And instead of just enjoying the meet and, you know, having fun pole vaulting, I turned it into, you know, I have to get this bar. I need to make this bar. And, you know, I learned my lesson from that. That's something I need to not do. I need to, as you will hear later from some of the elite vaulters, their biggest piece of advice is just have fun with it. Don't make a certain height or a certain bar, you know, the end of the world if you don't make it or if you do. Just have fun. And, you know, that's the lesson that I learned today. I tried to, you know, just probably tried too hard. I just needed to relax, have fun. And yeah.
Is. Hey, say, 5, 4, 3.
Oh. Hey, so we just got back from the meet. I didn't perform as well as I would have liked. I didn't do it on purpose, but I mean, this is a good example of why I made this channel, so that you can see, you know, what it's like. It's not always, you know, really good. You don't always have a good day. Sometimes, oftentimes you have a bad day, and, you know, it can be really hard mentally. But I mean, you gotta figure out what you did wrong and learn from it. Every day, good or bad, is an opportunity to learn something new. I feel like I did that today. I, you know, started off on a pole that was probably a little bit too big for me, or not too big for me, but in my mind, I should have started on a smaller pole and made my way up, but I didn't do that. I tried to make it work and just got in my head. So, you know, I learned next time, maybe just trust my head, start on the pole that I think I should start on, the softer pole, work my way up. Anyway, so I don't know if I'm going to put it in before or after, but I did ask a couple questions of the professional and elite pole vaulters that were there. So I'll put those in there. It's a good example of, you know, these guys are where I'd like to be, where a lot of young pole vaulters would like to be. And so you get to, you know, hear their thoughts on how to get to where they're at and, you know, how to process everything, whether you have a good or a bad day. So yeah, overall, I didn't let my poor performance ruin the meet for me. I still had fun. I still enjoyed it. Yeah, there's a lot of really good vaulters that, you know, jumped really high. So I'll put a couple of videos in there of that. And yeah. So I guess the lesson of the day is, whenever you have a bad day, you know, don't let that ruin the rest of your day, the rest of your, you know, whatever you're doing the rest of the day, the rest of the meet. Don't let it get you down. Just figure out what you did wrong, learn from it, and enjoy the rest of the day. So yeah, I hope you enjoy the video. Like I said, I'll put some clips of the professionals going, some of their jumps, and hope you enjoy it. See you next time. Also, another thing, I'm using a selfie stick that I bought at Target. It's not the best piece of equipment in the world, so you'll see in some of the videos it kind of turn and is at an angle, so I apologize for that, but we did the best we could, so just try to ignore that.
Biggest piece of advice for any vaulter is the importance of a good warm-up. You always have to get out there, and you always have to make sure that you're feeling the same way before you get out on the runway.
All right, so start out, for those that don't know who you are, say your name and PR if you don't mind.
Yeah, for sure. My name is Nate Richards. My PR is 5 meters 70, or 18 feet 8 and a half.
Okay. And if you could give one piece of advice to a young vaulter going to college or finishing their high school career, what would you say?
Yeah, I would say make sure you're having fun. Like, keep the fun in it. More often than not, you're going to perform better when you're having fun and you're not putting a lot of pressure on yourself. So just keep the fun in it and enjoy.
That's good. Thank you. So first I'll have you say your name and PR for people that don't know who you are.
Hey man, Tyler Krager, 478.
All right. And if you could give one piece of advice to a younger vaulter like myself, or, you know, anyone else out there, what would you say?
Definitely keep the fun, man. Like, don't wrap your identity in the vault. Like, win, lose, you're the same. Like, just enjoy it, man. Don't put, you know, pressure off. Just enjoy it. Once it becomes heavy pressure, you don't perform as well, and then you get frustrated. So keep it light.
All right, sounds good. Thank you, man.
What's up, man? Austin Miller, PR 573, 18.9 and a half. My one piece of advice would be, across the entirety of, like, the pole vault journey through your progress as a pole vaulter, got to take the highs and the lows with just as much credence for each one. You got to learn from both. And if you have an off day or like a real bad jump day or something, there's always something to be learned from it. And that is never an excuse to let it, like, take you down. You got to take it as another step towards bettering yourself as a pole vaulter.
All right, thank you.
Yeah, man.
All right, so first I'll have you say your name and PR for those that don't know.
My name is Cole Walsh, and my PR is 583, which is a good 19.1 or 2.
All right, and so with pole vault, you have a lot of good meets and you have a lot of really bad meets. So after a bad meet or a meet that you don't perform as well as you would want to, what advice would you give to a pole vaulter to be able to come back from that or not feel that it's as bad?
Yeah, man, I mean, every meet, good or bad, is a learning experience, right? When we jump well, we understand what it takes to put up big marks, and we can feel that feeling of a good performance, right? And we can remember it for later on. But when we don't perform well, it's not the end of the world. It's not a testament to what you are as an athlete. It's just you figuring out the wrong way to do it, right? Thomas Edison or whoever tried like 150 some odd ways to make a light bulb, and all 150 of those didn't work, but one way worked. And you gotta iron out the kinks and learn all of the things that can keep you from performing well. We've been competing all week together. I had a couple of no heights earlier in the week, man, and I was discouraged, but I used it as a learning experience. I figured out, you know, what I was doing wrong, you know, what I could do better. And there's no looking back, there's only looking forward. And the best way to improve is learning.
I like that, sounds good.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Thank you.